Welcome to Grip TV. I'm your host, Warren Davis.
Welcome back to Grip TV. This is Team of BD.
Welcome back to Grip TV. I'm your host, Maya Arrington. My friends call me Maya Arrington.
All grace abound, come on now. God is able to make all grace abound. Yeah, God is able to make all grace abound. Yeah, God is able. God is able. God is able. It says that God is able to make all grace abound, having all sufficiency in everything you would ever need for every good deed. Okay, I'm telling you, you pray to God for a good reason, He's going to give you what He wants to give you. Now, you may not understand it. You may pray for a Cadillac, and He may give you a Hyundai, but that's okay. He knows what you want. And ultimately, what we're going to pray for is His will to be done. Thy will be done, not mine. It's right there in the Our Father. Okay? So, amen. That's what we want to pray for. And we also want to make sure that you have the opportunity to get baptized today. Okay? You have an opportunity to change your eternity forever. Forever, okay? All you have to do is make one decision. One, the most important decision of your life is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I have no fear. Jesus, your name I love to hear. Your grace covers all my days.
What's up, Philadelphia? Yo. I said, what's up, Philadelphia? Yo. If you are blood bought, saved through grace by faith, filled with the Holy Ghost. Let me hear you make some noise. Hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. So this way, those who aren't believers can hear what it sounds like when you just praise the Lord. Come on. Thank you for the sisters that just shared up here. I appreciate you, sister, for sharing your testimony. I know the word says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb. And what else? By the word of our testimony. Come on. So somebody needed to hear what the sister had to say. I know people up here asking, who is that? I go by the name of King Rich. I am a Christian hip-hop artist all the way from South Jersey. All right, shout out South Jersey. Glass girl out here. G-Pro. Make some noise. Hallelujah. I've been coming to the Jesus Christ block parties for probably 4 or 5 years now. It's always a blessing to be out here. It's always a privilege and an honor to get to big up the name of the Lord Jesus out here. Because we know that demons flee at the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody. Hands up. Hands up. If you know that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and call it to his purpose, check this out. Woo! I say, I ain't got to worry, cuz I know God working for me. He deserves the praise. Hey, worship on that in the glory. I can say I'm changed. That would be a good story. I can say I'm saved. And the Lord, the one that did it for me. Woo! He write my wrong. He write my songs. Yeah, even when I can't see him. Look, right there alone. Long time in the bondage. Still holding on. Some say I'm lame in Jesus' name. I'm still standing strong. That devil tried to lock me down. Had me in that prison cell. Thinking that I just deserve it because I wasn't living well. That's another lie coming straight from the pit of hell. Gates is open wide over God. They cannot prevail. Now I can tell. Put me on the trail. He slow my roll. He moved me like a snail. I'm running fast, thinking it'll help me get to heaven. Walking with Jesus, I win. Cause you can never fail. I ain't got to worry, no. Hey, say I ain't got to worry, no. Hey, no, I ain't got to worry, no. No, it's work for me. Hey, it's work for me. You say, I ain't got to worry, no. Hey, see, I ain't got to worry, no. Hey, yeah, no, you ain't got to worry, no. Hey, it's working for me. It's working for me. Listen, she's in my way. Yeah, look, this be that day. I replace every ounce of fear with abundant faith. Yeah, see, I believe I receive just what I pray. So this the day I tell them giants that I'm not afraid. They come against me with everything. Short spear, everything. I come against them in the name. Five smooth stones in the staff of slang. And I'm screaming out, kudos, 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 Jehovah Zavio. Through faith by grace, no broken bones. Come in the name of the Lord of hosts. Woo! He fight my battles. The battle's his. He keep his covenant and all his promises. The King of glory, that's who he is. Hey, Jehovah Tiskanu, the Lord all righteous. While I'm under attack, the Lord is there. Help me slay the lion and then kill the bear. Any giant that went ever dead. Now the world know that the Lord is here. Some giants big, some tall, but the bigger they are, the harder they fall. So I'm not afraid, not at all. In the name of the Lord Jehovah Shemar. That's right. Hey, who's slaying giants? Now if I got some giant slayers out here, this your part right here. This is what we do. I slay. Every giant that'll get up in my way. Hey, this your mantra. Yeah, see, I slay. Every giant that'll get up in my way. Look.
This is my son, Sean McHale.
Hi, Papa.
This is due to drugs. Drugs did to my family. I'm going to give you a little bit of my testimony. I was born in South Philadelphia. I didn't know Jesus Christ at all. Growing up at a young age, drugs came into my life. Drinking at a young age, 13 or something like that, 16. Around 18 years old, I started stealing cars left and right. I was taking cops on high-speed chases, the state of New Jersey, Southwest Philly, all over. Later on, I was firebombing cars. I went to jail in 1989, and somebody told me about Jesus Christ then. And I asked for Christ in my life then, but I didn't do nothing with it all then. Later on, I got out, only a couple months in jail with 3 years probation. I met my baby's mother, and I had two daughters and a son, and that was baby Shawnee. Drugs came in our life like a flood. I never even knew crack cocaine. I was introduced to crack cocaine, and it destroyed my life. My son was born with crack cocaine addicted. He had to be on a feeding pump like 12 hours a day. And I neglected my children. I'm standing here as a witness for Christ, what God has did in my life. And I repented for my sins. You know, my baby's mother, me and her, were getting high one day. Her and her friend set up a plan to stab me in the heart. So she asked me for a hug and kiss. One knife went through my heart and put three holes in my heart. And I'm not supposed to be alive. I barely made the 911 call. Where's that poster with me with the blood on the ground? Where's it at, Joe? That one step to the cross. This is a real picture of me.
Stop it.
On the blood of the payphone hanging right there. What happened was I barely made the 911 call, and the phone, I passed out, and the phone was hanging.
No,
and the ambulance got in there, and they started cutting me and giving me inserted a tube in my lungs for me to breathe. I woke up from open heart surgery. I still had two more holes in my heart. The Lord was calling me, and I wrote to follow the Lord, and my heart would go, S-s-s. I was out there smoking crack, shooting dope again for another year and a half with my heart going, S-s-s, every time I smoke crack. I was up to 6 packs of cigarettes a day. I was on every drug you could think of right here. Let's say alcohol, Xanax, Lorset, Valium, Vicodin, methadone. I've been in and out of prison many times in institutions. Rehabs, Percocets, marijuana, cocaine too I did. Oxycontin, lost my children twice to DHF. Stabbings, I'm going to get to that, what happened after that. And methadone. Later on I went to jail, and then somebody told me about Jesus Christ. Somebody told me about being born again. See, when you're born again, you get the power of God. You get the resurrection of Jesus Christ in your life. And then you can overcome anything. So, and they told me that Jesus Christ had a plan for my life. The Bible says in Jeremiah 29:11, says, "For I know the plans I have for you, Sean Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you, but give you a future and a hope." So I got saved, and I started lifting up the name of Jesus, cell by cell. Taking the worship and teaching these guys how to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I went down for my plea bargain, and they said, "Mr. Lower, you're looking at 15 years in jail. You stabbed them all the way up by the chest. They weren't lowering my bail or nothing." I said, "Okay, well, I'm going to take a trial. Even though I did it, I'm going to plead guilty for it. But that's too long, 15 years in jail, because we were both getting high." The Holy Spirit just saturated me. The Holy Spirit led me back to the cell. I couldn't believe this happened. And opened the Bible. I didn't know how real the Bible was. And it went to Psalms 142. And if you read Psalms 142, everybody was making fun of me out there because I was lifting up the name of Jesus all over the place. And it says, "Nobody cares for you, Sean Lower. I'm adding my name because the Bible is a living word of God. When you read it, it's living. Nobody cares for you, Sean Lower. But guess what? I'm going to set you free from your prison because you're going to praise my name up and down the streets everywhere I'm at." Because we must be lifting up the name of Jesus all over the place. Now, I had no vision on that. The Lord, I wrote two books, and two books, and the Lord, right now, I am I'm a police chaplain at the 9th District now, at the Philadelphia Police Department. Taste and see how good the Lord Jesus Christ is. Anyone keeps their mind stayed on Jesus Christ is in perfect peace.
His name is Ralph.
Give him a hand.
Thank you. Again, my name is Ralph. I'm actually over at the Hope House in 9th and Cantrell. I was born and raised in a Christian family, in a Christian household. It was very difficult to come up here. I'm not used to being in front of people, but I'm just kind of excited to be able to just give my testimony real quick. I was always close with the Lord when I was young. I was probably around 13, 14 when my parents went through a lot that kind of hit me kind of hard. At that time, it was a little difficult for me. They separated for a long time, and then when I started getting involved with drugs, and it was all simple stuff. You know, I started drinking a lot, just smoking, whatever it was. But it just kind of progressed throughout the time. I mean, by the time I was 15, 16, I was on probation for over a year, and then in and out of jail. It was just all real stupid things. I mean, I was young, I was dumb, but you know, the Lord's always there. Even the times where I just fell away from Him, He was always watching over me. You know, being at this Hope House, and I've been here for, I got roughly three and a half months clean right now.
Woo!
And, thank you. And it's been real powerful being there, because He really, He's been opening my heart and my eyes to just, you know, how much He loves me through all of this. And,
hi everybody, my name is Dawn Yotis, and I'm definitely a recovering alcoholic and a drug addict. From tragedy to triumph, I walk through it all, and I'm inspired by it all. Though sometimes I get feared up, I know that God is my Savior. He walks me through everything. He even walks me from here. So I'll tell you what it's like and what it used to be like and how it is now. I have been delivered from alcohol and drugs, and that's only by God's good love and grace. And I will say I've been sober since June 5th, 2006, and I owe it all to Jesus Christ Himself. I came up here, I was so feared up, and now I'm like, whoo, thank you, Jesus. Amen, I owe it all to Him. So I was brought up and raised at Six and Wolf. Single mother. My father really wasn't around. And my mom struggled. My brother was alcoholic. I was brought up in an alcoholic house. And I only say that because my brother does recognize himself as a recovering alcoholic for 27 years. So, I don't know, I always felt inadequate as a kid because my father was never really around. So when we go to school and it was just parent meetings and it was just my mother that was there, I felt uncomfortable. So I started out, before I even picked up alcohol and drugs, I started out with lying and all the behaviors that an addict would have. So when people would ask me, like, where's your dad? I would lie. I didn't know no better. I would be like, oh, he lives in California. He's this big lawyer. Because I was just ashamed. I didn't know that things happen, you know? And so from there on, I started using. I started drinking first, and then it led on to other things. And I'll tell you what, it broke me down faster than I could ever imagine. And I will tell you this, I thank God for my bottom. I thank God that God delivered me. And I know that I owe all the glory to Him.
Wait on God. Wait on God. His timing is always right. I'm about to read a poem. It's called Wait. Desperately, helplessly, longingly, I cried. Quietly, patiently, lovingly, God replied. I pled and I asked for a clue to my fate. As the master replied, child, you must wait. Wait? You say wait? My indignant reply, Lord, I need answers. I need to know why. Is your hand short? Have you not heard? By faith, I have asked that I'm claiming your word. My future and all to which I can relate hangs in the balance, and you tell me to wait? I need a yes. I need a go-ahead sign, or even a no to which I can resign. And Lord, you promised that if we believe, we need but to ask and we shall receive. And Lord, I've been asking, and this is my cry. I'm weary of asking. I need a reply. Then quietly, softly, I learned of my fate as the master replied, once again, you must wait. So I slumped with my head, defeated and taut, and I said to the Lord, so I'm waiting for what? He seemed then to kneel, and his eyes wet with mine. He gently said, I could give you a sign. I could shake the heavens. I could darken the sun. I could raise the dead, cause the mountains to run. You would have what you want, but you wouldn't know me. You'd not know the depth of my love for the saint. You'd not know the power that I give to the faint. You'd not learn to see through clouds of despair. You'd not learn to trust me just by knowing I'm there. You'd not know the joy of resting in me when darkness and silence was all you could see. You would never experience that fullness of love as the peace of my spirit descends like a dove. You would know that I give and I save for a start, but you would never know the beat of my heart. the glow of the comfort late in the night, the faith that I'll give you if you walk without sight. The debt that's beyond getting what you want, and the debt that's beyond getting just what you ask of an infinite God who makes what you have last. You would never know if your pain quickly flee what it means that my grace is sufficient for thee. Yes, your dream for that loved one overnight could come true, but oh, what the loss if I lost what I'm doing in you. So be patient, my child, and in time you will see that the greatest of gifts is to get to know me. And often my answers seem terribly late. My most precious answer of all is wait.
She thanks the Lord for saving her.
Anything else? All right, we're going to pray. We're baptizing you, right? That's right. One, two, three. We baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Oh, yeah. Under. All right.
That's a fully submerged baptism. That's what the Bible teaches. You got to be dead. Got a resurrection power. Hey. Anyone in Christ Jesus is a brand new creation. Again, behold, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are come new. Whoever's watching this needs to be praying for all these people that have been baptized tonight. Count three, right? One, two, three. Baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I raised the light. Oh, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Look at the camera. Her name is Maya. Today, she's going to declare that Jesus Christ is Lord, and she's going to be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And everybody's watching this. You need to be praying for her right now that God sets her on fire. There's nothing better than lifting up the name of Jesus Christ up and down these streets.
Got one, two, three.
We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Man, the powerful Holy Spirit in Jesus' name.
There is power in the
power. He was trying to drown
you. Trying to hold your mother. Maya. He was trying to really cleanse you, right?
You're almost like me. You need an extra water.
You got some of my
head nails. Maya.
that we've given you, if you can hold them up. And after each name, we're going to ring a bell and we'll give a moment of silence, okay? The first one is John Labar. Matt Nichol. John Dickerson. Brandy Miller. Jose Rivera Perez. Bob Luther Sr. Mike Marfa. Victor Felisky. Help me with this, okay? I need some of these names. Brandon Scott. Jessica McEwen. Emmett Williams. Samuel Naya. Randy Miller. Philly Vick.
Quiet.
Chris Conroy. Dana Marie Cassidy. Bobby Rooney. Michael Rooney. Kelly McHale. Heather McHale. Shawnee McHale. The whole family is gone. John? Wow. Karasharis? Darlene Karasharis? God, Lord have mercy. Mark Anthony Rivera? Johnny Labar again? Okay, these are duplicates. Maureen Green? Deborah Hannon? This John Labar, I found him on all the pages. I don't know if there's multiple family members here. But
I'm not getting
you.
That's it. No more.
Sean Leary. Frankie Janus. Tommy Casella. Cabella. That's Tommy Cabella. I remember him. Yeah. Reggie Cook. Iris Tyson. Kristen Roof. Angel. John. Stephen Murph. C.C. Miller, Ed Moore, Timothy Baggett, and Raymond. No. Who?
Where's his bottle?
Randy Saul?
Yeah, he was up the Lord.
All right, calm down, Pop.
Okay.
He's home with the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can we pray, please? Father God, we thank you for these family members that are here, that are lifting up their loved ones, knowing that you have them in your presence, Father. Because it says in the word that absent from the body is present with the Lord. We thank you for preparing that place for each one of us, Lord. We thank you that in your time and in your will is when you come and receive us to yourself. And in those times, Father God, is where we find our hope. Our hope is at the cross and what you did that day on Calvary 2,000 years ago, Father. We thank you for that promise that you would reunite, reconcile, make us right with our Father so that we can be welcomed back into the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Everybody stay.
Matthew chapter 5. And he came over onto the other side of the sea into the country of the Gadareans. And when he had come out of the ship, immediately met him one out of the tombs with an unclean spirit, who had his dwellings among the tombs, and no man can bind him, no, not with chains, because he had been often bound with fetters, meaning he's been cuffed with his wrists and with his ankles, and with chains. And chains had been plucked ashore by him, and the fetters broken in pieces. Neither could any man tame him. And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying. That word crying in the Greek is he was screaming night and day, and cutting himself with stones. But when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshiped him. Not like we're worshiping him today, that he ran and he gave homage who Jesus is. And he cried with a loud voice and said, What have I had to do with thee, Jesus, the Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not. For he said unto him, Come out of the man, that unclean spirit.